Deception detection is the ability to discriminate lies and truths. If you think about it, just guessing is 50% accuracy, or a chance accuracy. The veracity effect says that truth accuracy is typically higher than lie accuracy. That's because of something called the truth bias, which means we typically expect truth, and so when we're just guessing, we have a 50-50 chance, but we guess truth more than lies. But there are four possible decisions that could be made. Truth could be seen as truth, which would be truth accuracy. A lie could be seen as a lie, which is lie accuracy. A lie could be seen as the truth, which is a false positive. It means the liar passes the test, but they're getting away with a lie. Or a truth could be seen as a lie. That's a false negative. It means truth tellers are wrongly accused. Some people call it the Othello error from the Shakespearean character who thought everybody was lying. So how good are we at detecting deception? The best way to understand accuracy rates is to look at well-conducted meta-analyses. What's a meta-analysis? It's a study of existing data that combines results from a variety of studies and looks for patterns of results across multiple studies. There have been hundreds of studies on human detection accuracy done by scholars over the past 40 years. Some show very high rates of a deception accuracy, up to about 90%, but some show very low rates, around 30%. A meta-analysis can look for overall patterns and different factors that might account for the variations. In deception, the biggest factor that accounts for the variation is sample size. When a large sample is used, the results are closer to what the overall pattern of results is than when a small sample is used. Bigger samples make your data more reliable. There are several meta-analyses out there, but the best-known one was done by Bond and DiPaolo in 2006. They looked at deception accuracy reported in 206 studies and found that the average detection accuracy is 54%. Think about that. You could flip a coin and be right 50% of the time, so it means we're performing only 4% better than chance. These samples are generally people who have no special training on detecting deception, but we'll look at the accuracy rates of professionals in a moment. The Bond and DiPaolo study also revealed a pretty clear truth bias. 47% of lies were correctly detected, while 62% of truths were correctly detected. If people are guessing, they are more likely to guess truth than lie. Professional samples don't do much better. A review by Vry and Mann in 2005 across 14 different studies of police officers, judges, intelligence analysts, and other experts showed that their accuracy ranged from 40% to 73%. And that in several of the studies, they had a higher lie accuracy rate than their truth accuracy rate, which suggests they might have a lie bias. If you think about the goals of a police investigation, they're trying to determine who committed a crime after it occurred. It's very important that they correctly judge lies from truths and not arrest or convict the wrong person. As the English jurist Blackstone once said, "It's better for 10 guilty persons to escape than one innocent suffer." This is the basis of the presumption of innocence in our legal system. It would favor the truth bias and the false positive error. However, if you're trying to prevent a future bad act like a terrorist attack, the intelligence community would favor a lie bias. That is preferable to falsely accuse an innocent person than allow 10 terrorists to carry out their plots. I want you to think about that. Which do you think are more harmful, false positives or false negatives, and why? If we're so bad at deception detection, is there any hope for us? Can we be trained to see the truths and lies correctly? Training thus far has had pretty pitiful results. Training programs have been developed for law enforcement and other important groups by a variety of sources, but have only been moderately successful, and the long-term effects of the training are questionable at best. Vry reports in his study of 18 different training studies that the average detection accuracy improves less than 5% after training, from 53.4% for untrained samples to 57.66% for trained samples. Now remember, 50% is chance, so you could get that just by flipping a coin. One. In a clever study comparing a valid training program to a bogus training that gave people no information at all, Tim Levine and his colleagues increased accuracy the same amount, no more than about 5% in either one over people who got no training at all. The bogus training probably did the same thing the valid training did. It made people more vigilant and careful about observing behavior, and that's about it. Further, Driscoll reports in his recent meta-analysis of 16 studies testing the effects of training on nearly 3,000 trainees that training can have a moderate effect overall, but that the type of training can affect the results. Training that combines information about the correct relevant cues, such as tension, the logic of the answers, and vocal fluency, with an ability to practice their skills and with feedback on accuracy, was the most effective. Driscoll's meta-analysis also found that training was more effective for naive trainees than people with training experience in deception detection. In fact, he says at least one study suggests that training may make police officers worse after the training than before. Driscoll speculates that ineffective stereotypes have been taught to professionals and make it more difficult to undo their misconceptions than the vague misperceptions of lay people. Several studies support this idea, suggesting that experienced professionals are more confident in their judgments than lay people, but are no more accurate. The troubling effect of this fact is that professionals might not believe they need further training. Although few studies have examined the impact of training on long-term changes in the behavior of professionals, these results suggest that without repeated training, police officers and others like them may simply fall back into their old bad habits relatively quickly. In order to be effective, training must be scientifically credible, must engage the trainees, and must be ongoing for long periods of time to avoid the pitfalls of other training systems. In this module, we've talked about the accuracy rates of deception detection, and we've discovered that, on average, we're no more than 54% accurate when trying to distinguish truths from lies. Can training make us more accurate? It can, but it needs to be good training based on scientifically validated studies and that gives good feedback to the people that are being trained. There's hope for us, but we still have more to learn.